श्रीकृष्णा 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 गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुसाक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः. When we fix any goal in our life, we become obsessed. And when we become obsessed, we may be committed, but that doesn't lead to the spiritual unfoldment in life. Spiritual unfoldment takes place when you are absolutely free. No obsession of any kind. I'll give you some examples about it. I was once somewhere in India and my talk was on Bhagavad Gita. After the talk was over, one gentleman came. He said, Swamiji, you should give talks in all our schools for the children. Children need this knowledge. I kept quiet. He said, what are your plans? I kept quiet. Then I asked him, since how long you are listening to Gita? He said, this was my first lecture. I said, what is your age? He said, 60. I said, till now you have not heard Gita. Did it make any difference? Now after listening, you want the children to know. What about you? See, we are all interested in improving the world. We are all interested in improving the society, not ourselves. See, Bhagavad Gita very clearly demonstrates this principle. The whole Bhagavad Gita was spoken by Bhagavan Krishna in front of Arjuna directly. Not like I am talking to you, Bhagavad Gita. He is indirectly. He spoke directly. And in that, how many things he told? One? Hundreds. The path of karma, the path of yoga, the path of bhakti, the path of knowledge. And there are 1.5 dozen yogas in Bhagavad Gita. Arjun, Vishada Yoganam, Sankhya Yoganam. How many of them? Did Arjuna practice any one of that? And we unnecessarily keep on struggling. Don't struggle in life. See, the question is, what happened then? So, for that we have to understand, how many people heard Bhagavad Gita? First, Arjuna heard from Bhagavan Sri Krishna, number one. Second, Sanjaya heard from Bhagavan Krishna. He tells in the 18th chapter, Vyasa Prasada Shrutavan Etat Guhyamaham Param. By the grace of Bhagavan Veda Vyasa, I have heard this Bhagavad Gita. Then the third person who heard was Dhritarashtra. Dhritarashtra heard it from Sanjay. Three of them. The teacher and the student, the teacher and the student, the teacher and the student, or the speaker and the listener. And the fourth one is, I am talking to you and I imagine you are listening. I can only imagine. How do I know whether you listen or not? If you are preoccupied with anything, you cannot listen. Now, after hearing this Bhagavad Gita, what happened to whom? First, has anything happened to Dhritarashtra? There is no mention anywhere in Bhagavad Gita that after listening to Bhagavad Gita from the mouth of Sanjaya, Dhritarashtra changed or did not change. Because nothing happened to him. He was blind by birth. we are deaf by birth. We don't want to listen to anybody. What I say is the right. See, friends. Now, such people, when they get into the world, what will be their approach? See, for example, suppose I am a student of Gita, I respect, love Gita, then what I can think? Everybody in the world should study Gita. Why everybody should study? See, this is not your property, the world is not your property, what others should do. But we get obsessed. So, nothing happened to Dhritarashtra. Then the second thing. What happened to Sanjay? Sanjay also heard from Bhagavan Krishna. Sanjay very clearly tells that after having heard Bhagavan's dialogue, I was so happy, so happy. And he concludes, where these two things come together, Yogeshwara Krishna and Dhanurdhari Partha. Yogeshwara Krishna is knowledge, Dhanurdhari Partha is action. When these two things come together perfectly, their success in the outer world and peace in the inner world is bound to be. This is what he has understood. This is what happened to him. So he was very happy. Then what happened to Arjuna? Third pair. Arjuna was asked by Bhagavan Krishna, Kachid eta shrutam partha tvaya ekagrena chetasa kachid ajnana sammoha pranashtaste dhananjaya. Hey Arjun, did you listen with single-pointed mind or not? Second thing, he said, has your delusion gone? And Arjuna's answer is, Nashto mohaha smritihi labdha tat prasadat maya achyuta stitosmi gata sandeha karishye vachanam tava. My delusion is gone. Then, I have collected my wits. Now I know what for I am here on the battlefield. Okay. So, Nashto moha smriti labdha tat prasadat maya achyuta stitosmi gata sandeha. No, I have no doubt whatsoever. This is what happened to Arjuna. Now the question is, what happens to us? We have heard satsanga throughout our life. What happened to us? To us, yes, we can tell nashta smriti, moha labdha, tvat prasadat, maya achyuta, stitosmi gata sandeha, no, gatosmi stita sandeha, I am more confused. See, friends, study of scriptures is meant for evolution. Not changing the world, not changing the society. This is where on a spiritual path, we step with all sincerity and get derailed. Goal is forgotten. See, what is the goal of our life? This is the topic given to me as a goal. See, now here, fortunately, there is no mic. Mic means Maya ka karya, mic. So when the mic is in front of you, in your hand, you don't want to give it up. Keep on talking. Probably that is the reason they have not provided me with the mic, so that I should keep my mouth shut. Okay. So, what is the purpose of that mic? Mic has no purpose. Whether the mic is kept in front of a Mahatma delivering a discourse, or the mic is in front of a disco dancer to sing a disco song. Mic has no problem. So mic has no purpose. The purpose is the person who is holding the mic in his hand. See? And how should be and what should be the mic? The mic should not add anything from his side when the speaker is talking. You must have seen many times it happens. When you start talking, the mic starts creating his own version. Either there is echo or there is electronic omkar, hum, or there is a noise. So when the mic starts talking and doesn't allow the speaker to talk, what do with such a mic? The mic is removed. In the same manner, we are the mic of the Lord. He has created us for some purpose. We have no purpose. We have no goal. Purpose is His. See. Now what should be then our life? Our life should be, we should remain a fit instrument. Mic should be a fit instrument. Then only it will be respected and held and used. In the same manner, we have to be a right and a fit instrument. Then only the Lord will choose us to express and fulfill His goal, His purpose. It is something like this. Once in Vrindavan, there was a group of Mahatmas sitting. This is a very old story. In 1930s, that time electricity, fans, they were not there. So, when the Mahatmas used to sit in the room, there used to be a big kind of a cloth hanging on the top, and somebody outside will be pulling it, and it will keep on moving. And that was a kind of a desi fan for the people inside to sit cool. There was no AC, no fan, no nothing. Some of you might have seen also. So the Mahatmas were sitting inside, and one of the devotees of the Mahatmas, he was, you know, pulling the string, sitting outside, very hot. And the fan was going on, Mahatmas were sitting comfortably. And then after some time, he became so emotional, that in that emotions, he fell down. So naturally, when he fell down, Mahatmas won't sit. They got up and they lifted him. And he said to his guru, Maharaj, I felt myself so lucky that I am serving at a time so many Mahatmas. How great lucky I am. And therefore, out of that emotional onslaught, I fell down. The Guru Maharaj said, hereafter, you will not do any work of mine. He said, why Maharaj, why not? As he said, you are not a fit instrument. See? Fit instrument is the one wherein we don't add anything from our side. Like the translations. Many people, when they do translation, one of my book was translated, or two I think, in Gujarati. And also some book was translated in Hindi. So, the book which was translated in Hindi by somebody showed me. I saw that. I said, oh, very good. Keep it. I'll see it. And I never published it. And that lady again and again asked me, Swamiji, what happened to my book? You know, you are not publishing it. I said, look here. I thought you are wise enough to understand when I am not talking on that topic. That means it is not accepted. Why? I said, because you have not translated it. You have added from your side your views. That is not translation. See, friends, in the same manner, we add from our side. What Lord has created for us, do that job. Nothing less, nothing more. That is the goal of our life. So we must remain a fit instrument physically, mentally, intellectually, and spiritually. Four parts. So what is the goal of our life? Physically fit, first goal. Let us not be a burden to anybody in this world. See, many times when we are not physically well, instead of keeping ourselves within the limits of our abilities, we want to go everywhere, here and there. And because of us, so many people are troubled that we don't realize. Very important thing. If you have got a paid servant who is supposed to do, that's a different issue. But because of us, how many people are disturbed around us? We are not aware of that. Second thing is the mental fitness. Mental fitness is emotions are ornaments on our personality, but emotionalism, see, that destroys everything. See, friends. And what is our approach to the society? Our approach to the society is everybody should do what I tell. See, I read somewhere in somebody's books. Shah Jahan was, you know, put into jail by his son. And when he was in the jail, he was not able to do anything. He was kind of a house arrest. So he told his son, okay, you have captivated me, okay, I agree. Now can you do one favor for me? Give me some children to whom I can teach Quran. And he said, okay. And he gave him about 200 children. Collected, listen to it. Now what is the moral of the story? A person who has been in his whole life telling somebody to do this, do that, he cannot stop without telling something to somebody. If nobody is there, at least the servant is there. See, friends. And therefore, then we want to get into and tell what others should do. One of the most important spiritual practices. Like Arjuna, when whole Bhagavad Gita was heard, the situation of war did not change. It is Arjuna who changed. In the same manner, whatever spiritual life we are living, are we changing or not? And what is the change that comes as a result of spiritual practice? Again, Bhagavad Gita. Brahma Bhuta, a realized person. Brahma Bhuta, Prasannatma, ever cheerful. Third thing, Na Shochati, fourth. Na Kangshati, five. Samoham Sarva Bhuteshu, equanimous towards everyone. And that is called as Parabhakti. Mad Bhaktim Labhate Param. This is what happens if we are really walking the spiritual path. See, friends. But normally what happens? We want others to change. I'll give another example. Once I was somewhere, and they had a very old type of house, and then a big compound and a huge gate kind of thing. So the people talk, oh, Swamiji is coming in our house, you should behave properly, you should not trouble Swamiji. So they had twins, one boy and one girl. So when I went, the children were waiting, Swamiji is coming, Swamiji is coming. And first the girl, girls are smarter than boys. First the girl, maybe about 5 years or 4 years, she came running and jumped on me like an Alsatian. So I lifted her, hugged her, kissed her, and she said, Swamiji, I don't like your beard. I said, I don't like you. Now, whatever their sister has done, the twin brother has to do. So he also came running and he also jumped. And him also I hugged and kissed him. And he said, Swamiji, I like your beard. Now tell me, between these two, whom I will like? The one who accepted me as I am, is it not? But we want people to be according to our design. See, I received one WhatsApp. If you want a husband who will eat the food without complaint, who will just follow you, who will never become angry with you, and who will love you, and who will not argue with you, then get married to a dog. Dog can do all this. See, friends, human beings are different. But we want others to listen to us. As regard we are concerned, we will not listen to anybody. We want others to listen to us. See, friends, in the process of transfer of knowledge, nothing can be taught. Remember this principle. Darwinically speaking, we are all monkeys. According to Darwin's theory of evolution, we are monkeys. Monkeys learn only through mimicry. In the same manner, others learn from our lifestyle. What is our behavior? How do we live? Then the learning happens. But instead of learning happening, we want to teach others what others should do. This is not the goal of our life. Like many people ask this question. In Mathura, Vrindavan, somewhere I was going by train many years before. And there you come across many places it is written, Jai Gurudev, Satya Yuga Aayega, Jai Gurudev, Satya Yuga Aayega. So one person asked me, Swamiji, what is this? I said, you read, I don't know what it is. Now what they say Satya Yuga Aayega means what? I said, you tell me, what is today? They said, today is Sunday. I said, I proclaim, Monday Aayega. What will come after Sunday? Monday. What is the great thing about it? In the same manner, what is the present yuga? How many days are there? 7 days. There are not 10 days. And it's a cycle. How many yugas are there? 4. Satya, Treta, Dwapar, Kali. There is no 5th yuga. Now we are in the Kali yuga. Now what will be the next? Satya yuga aayega. Oh, it is that simple. I said, Satya Yuga will not come outside. It must come inside. Satya Yuga is, you remain Sat-oriented. See, when we become spiritually awakened, that is Satya Yuga. When we are emotionally awakened, that is Dwapar Yuga. When we are activity-wise awakened, that is Treta Yuga. And when we are effortlessly able to merge in the Absolute, that is the Satya Yuga. If you read Ramayana, in Ramayana, every now and there are stories. Sajjansa Yajna was going on and the Rakshasas came and destroyed. The Yajna business ends in Dwapar Yuga. In Dwapar Yuga, it is the Upasana, Bhakti, devotion that comes up. And in Kali Yuga, laziness. Aaja kare so kal kar, kal kare so parsu. Therefore, let us not get lost in all these imaginations. We have to, first goal of our life, remain cheerful and happy. And for no reason. See, if as a husband you are happy because your wife is good and serving, what is your contribution? If you are happy in spite of your wife, then you are a genius. See, friends. But we find out the reason, I am happy because, and that because never happens. See? So one such person, he asked me this question. Swamiji, you talk about Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavan Krishna and avatar and all kinds of things. When is your Krishna going to take avatar? I said, there's a lot of time, he told me, there's no hurry. He said, you know, such a terrible time is today, everywhere there is terrorism and there are, you know, many calamities and earthquakes and everything is happening. Why doesn't he come now? I said, there is no need, it's not a big deal, simple things are happening. I don't think, I said, okay, now you answer my questions. I asked him, was the world really very bad before? I don't think. The world was worse than today. Very good. Will the world be really bad afterwards? It can't be worse than today, Swamiji. Today's world is worst of all the time. Very good. Earlier you were there? No. Later you will be there? No. Now the world is horrible because you are there. You get out. See, friends. Bhagavan Krishna very clearly tells, na kartrutvam na karmani lokasya srujati prabhu, na karma phala sayogam svabhavastu pravartate. The doership is not created by us. Somebody asked me this question. Swamiji, God has created our sense organs. Yes. Then why should we control them? I said, don't control. Who asked you to control? No, no, they say control. I said, then control. Be attentive. We only suffer. And then we are the question. See. If you stop blaming the world for anything, you have no questions. Like one more example I'll give you. There is one lady, she told me, Swamiji, I have got some illicit relations with somebody. And I don't feel bad about it. What is wrong? I said, nothing wrong. Continue. No, I want to ask you. Is it wrong? I said, Mama, you are deceiving yourself. If you know nothing wrong, why you are asking a question? When you know which direction you have to go to Gayatri, Mandir, will you ask a GPS? Will not ask. When you ask a question, you are in doubt. In the same manner, do we ask any question about our being? Excuse me, will you please tell me whether I am there or not? No. Take this as a simple rule for your spiritual evolution, that about which we have no question, that is our essential nature. You are not struggling for keeping your mouth shut. We force. Yogaha chitta vritti nirodaha, keep silent. So outside silence, inside volcanoes. I was in Haridwar and was going with one of my friend in a, you know, this manual rickshaw. So my friend said, Swamiji, in this ashram there is a big Mahatma. I said, come on, we'll go and take darshan. So I went there. And big Mahatmas means they have got a very big official, things around. Secretary, president and everything. Then more the paraphernalia, bigger is the Mahatma, you know. So when I went there, secretary told, sorry, Mahatmaji is not available. He is in Maunam. Come, later. So, right. So I went out with my friend. After about a minute or so, again that man came running. Wait. I said, no, what happened? No, Mahatmaji called you. I said, how can he call me? He's in Maunam. He said, no, you come. Okay, I went. After I went, then both of us were wanting to go. Secretary says, "You can't come, go inside. Only Maharaji can go." I said, "Hang around, lucky." So I went inside. So I went inside alone. And Mahatmaji was sitting in a big chair. And one chair was given to me, plastic chair. Depending upon the quality, plastic chair was given. And he took paper and pen and wrote, "What's your name?" In Hindi he wrote. I wrote, "Gadwadananda." Then, "Where you come from?" Something I had to write, "Vrindavan." "Where are you staying here?" Some ashram name I wrote down. And then I realized, and he also realized, that he is observing Mauna, not me. I could have spoken. So when he asked me my name, "What is your name?" I could have told Swami Gadbadananda, but I wrote it down. And then I also realized, he also realized. And he also laughed, I also laughed. Then although I am not on Maunam, I am not talking. So when he laughed, then I asked him a question. "Maharaji, Maunam is laughing allowed?" See, friends. Gira Maunam to Bala Naam. Bhagavad Gita, if you are studying, Bhagavad Gita tells, Mana Prasada Saumyatvam Maunam Atma Vinigraha. This is the real Mauna according to Bhagavad Gita. Talk to others. Stop talking to yourself. Do this experiment. Not long, 30 seconds. Stop talking to yourself. Experiment over. Did I tell don't talk among each other? I told you only don't talk to yourself, is it not? When you stop talking to yourself, you don't want to talk to others. We do the other way around. Don't talk to others. Okay, andar mein grrr, 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 grrr. See, friends, unless we look within, these things will not come. Spend every day, whatever little time, starting from 30 seconds, anywhere you are sitting, right from your commode in the morning. When you sit on the commode, that time remember me and start this mantra. Don't talk, don't talk, don't talk, don't talk. Anywhere you get time, you are all alone, sitting in the chair, don't talk. Somebody comes and talks to you, "Mommy, I want food." "Okay, I'll give you." Talk to that child. "No, no." Dumb. See, friends, the real goal of our life is we are always cheerful and happy. And cheerful and happiness comes if you are at peace with yourself. Bhagavad Gita tells, Nasti buddhihi ayuktasya nacha ayuktasya bhavana nacha bhavayata shantihi ashantasya kuta sukham. We suffer maximum in our life because of ourselves, not because of others. Suppose I suffer because of her, I can go away. But where will you go away? Wherever you go, there you are. See, friends, we all know only working by the mind. Get this principle across very clearly. We know how to work by the mind. Working by the mind is comment on everything, evaluation of everything. If we are Indians as we are, giving suggestion to everybody including God. Every Indian is expert in somebody else's job, not his own job. Taking decision for others. I think you should get him married. Who asked you? But we take the decision, get him married. Then what will happen? Then our problem will be transferred. Friends. Instead of all, this is called as working by the mind in our day-to-day lifestyle. Working by the mind in your spiritual life. Working by the mind, we take the mala in the hand and start. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Working by the mind. Rather than counting the time, number of times you have chanted, spend more time in silence. Every thought takes us away from ourselves. Like when we ride our car, after riding the car, where do we go? We go away from our house, is it not? One day, somewhere, I just came out of my flat, sat in the car, and just to go. One person asked me, Swamiji, where are you going? I said, I am going to the bathroom in my room. Why you say like that? I said, when somebody sits in the car, he goes away. In the same manner, when we ride the vehicle of thought, we go away from ourselves. Spend more time with yourself. Ours is a non-stop chatterbox. Just imagine you enter a poultry farm and slowly go and sit down there quiet. The birds are birds. They will come pecking and they will peck you also. When the bird will peck you, you will get disturbed. The whole poultry farm will be disturbed. Exactly this is what happens inside. See, a real mauna is when you refuse to get disturbed. Let there be war around. That is what. Spend more and more time on this. The world was always like this. All the saviors. There was a great master in Bombay. His name is Nisargadatta Maharaj. He has a tremendous influence on my life. He used to say in simple, he was uneducated. Pan bidi shop. And when he used to say, because I say it is like that, not because your Bhagavad Gita says. That was his confidence. So he used to say, all the saviors of the world have come in this world. The world is as it is. They were shaved off. The world is the same. See, friends, don't bother about the world. Take care of yourself. Bhagavan says in Bhagavad Gita, उद्धरेद् आत्मनात्मानं नात्मानं अवसादयेत् आत्मैव आत्मनो बन्धु आत्मैव रिपुरात्मनः. And when we become capable, when we become a fit instrument, then the Lord will choose us and He will function through us. Therefore, Mahatmas never get insulted. They never claim that they have to do anything in life. Things happen through them. Like the bulb. Whether the bulb is in a temple or in a toilet, it makes no difference to the bulb. But we unwanted intellectuals, we have questions about everything. That is the reason I never entertain questions. In one place, there was this one gentleman came, Swamiji, can you tell me? I kept quiet. Why this bulb is in front of the Lord and that bulb is in the toilet? Why? Now what can you talk? No, Swamiji, you please tell me. This is our question. Why that person is born in a poor family? Why he is born in a rich family? Why he is having a MS right from birth? Why he is not having MS right? Why? Because the sky is too high. So, when such stupid questions are asked, answers cannot be wise. They are super stupid. So, when this person asks me this question, why this bulb is in the temple and why that bulb is in the toilet? What can I tell? I have to satisfy that dumb fellow. And what is satisfaction? Give some cause and effect relationship. The truth is, cause and effect is an illusion. There is nothing like cause, nothing like effect. Paramatma alone is the truth. So I had to reply, I said, look here, this bulb must have done lot of merit in his last life. And because of those merits, he is placed in a temple illuminating the God. Balba Ananda Maharaj ki. Then the second bulb is in the toilet, must be a terrorist, must be a cruel, must be a sinner, therefore he is in the toilet. Look at the dirty things. Two. Now these two things have happened. By the time you are talking, that bulb in the temple got fused. Swamiji, what happened? Bhagwan ko achhe log achhe lagte. That means all those who are living long, they are bad. Now what to do? Now don't bother about it. Remove that bulb from the toilet, fix it here. Because we have to do puja, aarti, everything. We can't go to the shop, shops are closed. So you remove the bulb from the toilet and fix it in the temple. But now why this bulb has come here? He must have done some punya in the last life. And see friends, be attentive. When the bulb is illuminating the gods in the temple and when the bulb is illuminating the filth in the toilet, does it make any difference to the bulb?
No.
Think. Whether I am seeing a dark black color with my eyes or see a red color with my eyes, does it make any difference to my eyes? Be attentive. Whether I hear the Lord's name by my ears or I hear the chirping of the birds or an abuse, does it make any difference to my hearing faculty? Whether there are good thoughts in the mind or bad thoughts in the mind, does it make any difference to the mind? Whether it is a waking, dream, deep sleep or samadhi, does it make any difference to me? Whether it was the childhood, middle age, old age, does it make any difference to me? Dehi nosmin yatha dehe kaumaram yovanam jara tatha dehantara praptihi dhirastatra namuyati. This is the truth. See, friends, abiding in this reality 24/7 is living in meditation. Instead of living in meditation, we do meditation. Is it upma? Meditation is never done. Do we do waking? We are in the waking experience and then conduct ourselves. Do we do dreaming? No. We are in the dream, then have funny things. Do we do deep sleeping? No. We are in deep sleep, then snore. Try to snore when you are awake. Similarly, we have to live in meditation and then conduct ourselves in this world. Bhagavan Krishna says this thing in Bhagavad Gita. Ya nisha sarva bhutanam tasyam jagrati sayami yasyam jagrati bhutani sa nisha pashyato munehe. A man living in meditation, he has a different perception of this world than a man not living in meditation. See, friends. Therefore, let us come back to our essential self. Being is natural. Becoming is unnatural. See? Being old is natural. To become young in the old age by makeup is unnatural. See? Being man is natural. Becoming husband is unnatural. So, man is never miserable. Husband, never happy. Because it is becoming. We should not become happy. We should be happy. In being, there are no efforts. In being, there is no beginning. In becoming, there is a beginning. See, when you become husband, you have become husband on a particular day, particular time. Before that, you are a man. And if the wife leaves and goes you away, then you cease to be husband, but you continue to be man. In the same manner, this the real self that we are, childhood came, we supported the childhood has gone. Then the teenage came, we supported the teenage, it has gone. The middle age has come, we supported that, it has gone. The old age has come, we are supporting. Let it go, who cares? Dhirastatra namuyati. Goal is that what you have to reach. Here it is a goal that you are already a goal. You don't have to reach anywhere. Praptasya prapti. We don't have to become divine. We have to allow the divinity that we are to manifest. And that manifestation of the divinity is arrested, stopped, because we get involved in too many things in this world. spend more and more time on the silence. In silence, mind gets dissolved like the ice cube gets dissolved in the waters without making a noise. One great Mahatma, he wrote, after having crossed the Bhavasagara or Bhavanadi, I was so happy that I wanted to thank my Guru and look behind the river that I have crossed. And lo, I came to discover there was never a river and there was never a Guru. I alone was. Mirabai, what she says, Bhavasagarava Sukha Gaya Hai. We were never miserable. We were never born. That eternal divine presence is not created by our sadhana. It is discovered when we stop doing everything. Therefore, the real spiritual practice is undoing, not doing anything. The real spiritual practice is not becoming someone, unbecoming. And this is what we every day do. What is deep sleep? Deep sleep is unbecoming. In deep sleep, we are neither mother, father, husband, wife, brother, sister, man, woman, young, old, nothing. We unbecome. And because we unbecome, we undo. Whatever you experience is the goal of your life. If sleep, never mind. Because in sleep also you are there. Therefore, we do not have any question or any doubt about our being. So when any question comes, ask this, again counter question. Is it about me? No. Why worry about the world? Spend time in this, without doing anything, without becoming anything, anybody. And undo all, unbecome all. There you are. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnahat Purnamudachate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishate Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Sri Guru Pyo Namaha Hari Om.